हरिणी साईचरण श्रीनवी
Can you repeat the question?
Type of numbers, you know, natural numbers, whole numbers, integers. Do you know the children? All of you on your cameras. Why all the cameras are off? So see, first of all, we just discussed with natural numbers. What are natural numbers? Do you know the children? What are natural numbers? Anyone can tell me what are natural numbers?
Sir, from 1 to infinite, sir.
Yeah, the counting numbers are natural numbers. Counting numbers are natural numbers. You can see here from 1 to infinity. Means all positive numbers starting from 1 is natural numbers. So counting numbers are natural numbers. Again, what are whole numbers?
Where there's 0 to infinite.
Yeah, we are just in counting numbers, just we are adding 0 over here. So counting numbers addition with 0 is called whole numbers. Okay, whole numbers. If we add 0 to the counting numbers, there is called as whole numbers. What about integers? What about integers?
The numbers which are having negative signs are called integers, sir. And positive signs.
Yeah, exactly. See, this is negative. All negative numbers are known as negative integers. And all positive numbers, these natural numbers, are called positive integers. What about 0? What we call about 0 here? This is 0.
Neutral?
Integer. Yeah, we can say here 0.
Neutral.
Yeah, neutral. We can say 0 integer. So all natural numbers, negative numbers, and 0 together are called integers. So negative numbers are called negative integers. Positive are called positive integers, and 0 is called 0 integers. Anyone can tell me what about natural number? Anyone can tell me what are
rational number can be a number which can be formed R by S when S doesn't equal to 0.
Yes. If I'm writing 2 by 3, is it a rational number?
Yes, sir. It is a rational number.
If I'm writing 5 by 0, is it a rational number?
No, sir.
Why this is not a rational number?
Because 0 is the denominator.
Yeah, 0 is denominator. So what is the value of 5 by 0? What is the value of 5 by 0? Anybody can tell me what is the value of 5 by 0?
Sir, not defined, sir.
Yeah, it's not defined. Not defined. If you are having any 5 rupees, okay, if you are having any 5 items with you and somebody told you to distribute among 0 people, okay, so you can't distribute, right? So this question is irrelevant. So the value of this is what? Not defined, okay, or you can say infinity. Suppose in case if I'm asking 0, is 0 is a rational number? Children, is 0 is a rational number?
Yeah.
Why this is a rational number? Why 0 is a rational number? Why 0 is called rational number? Anybody can answer?
Sir, because we can write 0 by 1, sir.
Yeah, 0 by 1. So we are writing in R by S form, where S is not equal to 0. So is it clear to everyone what are rational numbers?
Yes, sir.
Anyone having doubt? Sir. So we till now we understand natural numbers, whole numbers, integers, and rational numbers. How to find rational number between two given numbers? How many numbers you can find? Suppose I'm asking how many rational numbers are between 3 and 4? How many rational numbers are between 3 and between 2 and 4? How many rational numbers?
Infinite.
Okay. Tell me any rational number between 2 and 4.
3.
Okay, next. Next, any number between 2 and 4. First one is 3. See, they are infinite. Infinite means we can't count only. So tell me the other number which is between 2 and 4.
So
3.5. Yeah, 3.5. Any number you can write. Suppose 2, you can write here 4. Suppose you can write like 200 by 100. This is nothing but 2. We can write 200 by 100 if we write. We can write only 2. And 400 divided by 100 is nothing but 4 only. So between this 200 by 100 and 400 by 100, you can write so many numbers like 201 by 100, 202 by 100, so on. It's going, keep on going, 399 by 100. If you want again more, so you can just keep on increasing, okay? 2000 by 1000 you can write. You can keep on increasing numbers. So many infinite numbers you can write between any two numbers. This is the first method to find rational numbers between two numbers. You can write, you can add number of zeros how much you want over here, okay? So first method is you can put here number of zeros, 2 followed by 2 zeros by 100, 400 by 100. Suppose someone is asking you, I want 1000 numbers between 200 and 400, between 2 and 3, sorry. If someone will ask you, write 1000 numbers between 2 and 4, then what we can write? You can write here 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 zeros if you want, you can write here, followed by 1, 2, 3, 4. Again, 4 followed by 4 zeros you put, divide by 1, 2, 3, 4. You can write so many numbers you can write in between these two rational numbers. Till you are getting what I'm saying here? Because the value of this complete thing is nothing but 2. And this complete thing is what? 4. So whatever the number you are writing in between, like 2 followed by 301 divided by 1 followed by 0000, this is between what? 2 and 4. Is this clear to everybody? Children, is this clear?
Yes, sir.
Other method of this is you can just add 2 numbers and divide by 2. You can add 2 numbers and divide by 2. Like, suppose I'm asking here that's between 2 and 4. So between number, how to find the rational number between those two numbers? You can add 2 plus 4 divided by 2. Suppose first number is A and second number is B. So rational number between these two numbers is A plus B divided by 2. Okay. So what we get? 2 and 4 as it is. Between these two, what we get? 3. 2 plus 4, 6. 6 divided by 2, that there is nothing but 3. Again, we want a rational number between these two. Again, between these two. You can find easily. So what we can write rational number between these 2 and 3? 2 plus 3 divided by 2. Again, in between what we can write? 3 plus 4 divided by 2. Simply add these two numbers and divide by 2. Add these two numbers, divide by 2. Is it clear? So we can write here 2 plus 3, 5 by 2, we can write here number. Between 2 and 3, 5 by 2. Again, between 3 and 4, what we can write? 7 by 2. So rational numbers may be different, means you can write any number which lies between 2 and 4. So this is one other method what I have solved for you. So both methods are clear to you. This is your second method, method number 2, and that was first method. Children, both methods are clear to everybody. Anyone having doubt in the methods? First one or second one? Anyone having doubt in method one as well as method two? No one is having doubt, right? Okay. So next, here example is given over here. Find two rational numbers between 4 and 5. Find two rational numbers between 4 and 5.
Sir, I have a doubt.
Yeah, tell me.
Sir, why can't you solve it like writing 4 by 1 and 5 by 1 and then multiplying it by 2, since you have to find 2. So and then you get the numbers, and then you get two numbers, so then you choose the two numbers instead of this one.
Yeah, that also means you are saying that 4 by 1 and 5 by 1, again you are saying to multiply here by 2, right?
Yeah, sir, since
yeah
and both sides.
Yeah, exactly. See, this zero part is much easier than this two. You can do this part also, not a problem in that. But zero is more what is easier than any other whatever you do. You hear what you get? 4 to the 8 by 2, you 8 by 2 you get here, 10 by 2. So you get only 9 by 2 here, right? Yeah. If you want two numbers, again you have a problem, right? So 8 by 2 and 10 by 2, you'll get 9 by 2. So better what we are doing is just 4 by 1 is there, better we're writing 0, 0 here. Again, 5 by 1, better write 0, 0 over here. Okay. So that is much easier.
If you can multiply it by 3 also, it's going to work, right? You'll find 2 if you multiply it by 3 or 2 plus 1.
Exactly. 2, 3, whatever the number, if you have to multiply with numerator as well as denominator. Okay.
Okay.
So you can multiply with 2, 3, whatever the number is convenient to you, you can multiply. But if you see now here, it looks easier. That's why we are just preferring this, nothing else. Okay.
Okay. Yeah.
So here next example is find two rational numbers between 4 and 5. So what we have discussed right now, as he told that we have to multiply by 2 and all, but you can multiply by 3 also, you can multiply by 4 also, but you have to multiply with the same number in numerator as well as denominator. All right, children. So I think everyone can do this example number this one. So find two rational numbers between 4 and 5. And second method also you can apply, that is a plus 2 divide, but here that method is applied over here. That is a, b. So a plus b divided by 2. That is 4 plus 5 divided by 2. That is 9 by 2. This is your first one. Again, second one you can find. A1 is 4. 4 and 9 by 2 is there. You can add again divided by 2. So we'll get here 17 by 4. Okay. So both methods you can apply to find rational numbers between any two numbers. Now, second part of the number system, numbers is, you learned rational numbers right now. Second part is irrational numbers. So what are irrational numbers? The number A, which cannot be written in P by Q form, is called irrational. We cannot write in P by Q form. We cannot write in P by Q form, where P and Q are integers and Q is not a integer. You can say that the numbers are not rational are called irrational numbers. The numbers which are not irrational, the numbers which are not rational are called irrational numbers. So you can take any example like pi value, pi and 22 by 7. What is pi and what is 22 by 7? What is pi? Pi is rational number or irrational number?
Rational number, sir.
Which one is rational number? Pi is rational number or 22 by 7 is rational number?
So both are rational numbers because pi and 22 by 7 are same. Both are rational numbers.
Okay. Anybody else?
Yes, sir. The same answer because pi is equal to 22 by 7, no, sir. It is a rational number.
Okay. If you divide this 22 by 7, if you divide this, what you get, just check the answer.
It goes till infinity, 3.1.
Yeah, 3.14... We can't express actually, okay? Pi value, you can't...
Bar.
Bar also will not come. This will not repeat. See, in irrational number also, you'll get what? One, you get terminating, you know? Terminating, non-terminating and all. Terminating, we should not write. We should write here, non-terminating. Non-terminating, and second one is non-recurring. You have heard this these words, non-recurring. 3.14. Suppose if you are having 3.14144... So you can write it as 3.14 bar. We can write like this. Okay. So this is like rational numbers. If bar is coming, that is rational number. Okay. But here, this will not repeat anything over here. This is keep on going further. Okay. Pi value is 3.14... Keep on going. This is not going to end. And 22 by 7 is fixed. 22 by 7 is what? Fixed. This is in form of P by Q. So here pi is, what we call it as pi here? Rational or irrational? Children, tell me. Pi is rational or irrational?
Rational.
Rational.
Pi is irrational. Because, and this 22 by 7 is rational. See what is given here in the definition, just try to understand. The number A, which cannot be written in form of P by Q form. So 3.14... this number is keep on going and we doesn't know where it's going to end. You can write in P by Q form. Can you write in P by Q form? Anybody? Any one of you can write?
No, sir.
So that's why this pi is irrational number, whereas 22 by 7 is a rational number. It's clear? So irrational numbers are non-terminating. This is not going to terminate anywhere. The numbers which is not going to terminate, and non-recurring, that should be non-recurring also. So this both numbers are known as what? Irrational numbers. What we call it as? Irrational numbers. So this one, anyone having doubt about the irrational number? So right now, what and all we have learned? We have learned natural numbers, whole numbers, integers, rational number between two numbers, rational number between two numbers, and this one is irrational number. So what are real numbers? Now the thing is coming, what are real numbers? So all numbers, including both rational and irrational numbers, are called real numbers, whether it is a rational number or irrational number. That is called what? Real numbers. What is the opposite of real? What is the opposite or antonyms of real? Anybody can tell me? What is the opposite of real? imaginary. Imaginary numbers are real numbers. So what are imaginary numbers? Do you know? The numbers which is coming in root and should be negative. Should be negative. These numbers are known as imaginary numbers. That is, this is not in your syllabus. Imaginary part is not in your syllabus, but simply try to understand. Real numbers, all numbers, both rational or irrational numbers are called real numbers. What are imaginary numbers? The numbers which are written in root and which are negative inside it. So these all are imaginary numbers. The one flow chart is given over here of real numbers. See here, natural numbers, these all are the part of this whole egg shape is a part of real numbers, rational numbers. That is natural number, whole number, integers, rational numbers. And irrational number is which you can't be non-terminating, non-recurring. These all are irrational numbers. So including this both, rational as well as irrational numbers, we call it as real numbers. So anyone till so far you are having doubt in rational, irrational or any part of it?
Awesome.
Okay. Next we move further with, again just rational numbers we are going to again in brief what is rational numbers and all. If the rational numbers is in the form of A by B, then by dividing A by B we can get two situations. Either the remainder is zero or remainder is not zero. Okay. So when the remainder is zero in the last point, that is called terminating. Means it will get terminated somewhere. After this, you can't find anything. Okay. This 0.875. If any train is moving from Hyderabad to Bangalore, so here it got terminated to Bangalore. The train is got terminated to Bangalore. It means this got stopped till here. If the remainder becomes zero, it means after this 7/8, if you divide here 7/8, 0.0 will come here, then 8. 8 8s are 64. Again here 6, 60. So 8 7s are 56. Again here 4, 5s are 40. So this got terminated here. After this, you can't find anything and all. Okay. So once the remainder has become zero, and second, the remainder doesn't become zero. In this case, 1/3, if you find 0.333, this is not going to end anywhere. Okay. So there are two situations of the rational numbers. One is your remainder is zero. And second situation is remainder is non-zero. That's why I told you before, ki rational numbers may be like this, but irrational numbers are what? Irrational numbers are non-recurring and non-terminating. Terminating. Non-recurring and non-terminating. This is what? Terminated already. And this got record, that is 0.3 bar. This got record. So this is rational number. So this is also rational number. So this is known as what? Terminated. This got terminated. And this got record. Okay. But as per definition of irrational number, the number should be non-recurring and non-terminating. Hence the decimal expansion of rational numbers could be terminating or non-terminating, recurring, and vice versa. Hence, the decimal expansion of rational numbers could be terminating or non-terminating and vice versa. What are irrational numbers? Again, try to understand here. Same thing what I told here. If we do the decimal expansion of an irrational number, then it would be non-terminating, non-recurring. See, non-terminating, non-recurring, and vice versa. That is, remainder doesn't become zero and also not repeated. So example is 3.1415926. This is not going to repeat. So this is the basic concept of your first exercise of this chapter, okay? What we have learned till now, so this is the basic concept of first exercise. So any doubts, children, anywhere till what the numbers, what we have learned till now? Anyone having doubt? Any one of you?
No, sir.
No one. So we'll just do the exercise questions 1.1. Just tell the answers for this. Question number one is 0 a rational number? Is 0 a rational number?
Yes, sir, it is.
Can you write it the form of P by Q? And because we can write 0 by 1. So this is a rational number. Second one, find 6 rational numbers between 3 and 4. We can find easily. Which method will test going to find this? 3 and 4. Tell me the 6 rational numbers between 3 and 4. So you can write here 30 by 10, 40 by 10. And whatever is coming in between, you can write it off, okay? 31 by 10 dash 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 till 39 by 10. Again, find the 5 rational numbers between 3 by 5 and 4 by 5, 3 by 5 and 4 by 5, 0, 0, 0, 0. So we can write easily here also, 31 by 50, 32 by 50, dash, dash, dash. You can write whatever you want between these two. State whether the following statement is true or false. Give reason for your answers. First one, every natural number is a whole number. Every natural number is a whole number. It's true. Is it true or false?
True, sir.
Every natural number is a whole number. This is true. Now, every integer is a whole number. Every integer is a whole number.
False.
False, sir.
False.
False. Why? Why is this false?
So because whole numbers doesn't have negative numbers, sir, like integer.
Yeah, exactly. So every integer, integers here also. So this is not a whole number. This is not a whole number, not whole number. Okay. So now every rational number is a whole number. Every rational number is a whole number. Is it true?
True, sir. Yes, sir, it's true.
Suppose I'm writing here minus 2 by 3. Is it a whole number?
No, sir.
It's false or true? It's false or true? See, in the question, they are saying that every rational number is a whole number. So, minus 2 by 3 is your rational number. Is this minus 2 by 3 is your whole number? No, right? So this is a false statement. So far, no one having doubt, I think so, no? Please don't hesitate to ask doubts, okay? So, hope everyone is clear with all these basic concepts of numbers. Now we are moving to next topic. That is representing real numbers on a number line. How to represent numbers? How to represent real numbers on a number line? Okay. So question is, we have to represent 4.2626. We had to represent 4.2626. So the number lies between 4 and 5. So first of all, what you have to draw is, this number lies between what? 4 and 5. So just make the number line, there is 4 and 5 will be there. 4 and 5. So between 4 and 5, how many divisions are there? It's here 4.1, 4.2, 4.3, 4.4, 4.5, 4.6. You can just check it here. Down is mentioned here. See, we have to draw for 4.2626. So this lies between 4 and 5. So we have to mark here from 4.1 to 4.9 in the between. Okay. So again, 4.2626. Again, 4.2. Where 4.2 lies? See, this is 4.2 and this is 4.3. So this 4.2626 lies between this. Again, we have to zoom it across. 4.2 and 4.3, we have to zoom it. Again, this will come from 4.21. We'll write here 4.21 to 4.29. Again, we check 4.26 and 4.27. This lies between 4.26 and 4.27. Again, zoom this part, 4.26 and 4.27, you write here. Then we can write here 4.261, 4.262, dash, dash, dash till 4.269. Again, we have to get 4.2626. Again, 4.262263. So where is 2.2626 lies? See, here it is. This is the point of 4.2626. So mainly we have to keep on zooming the digits numbers. Okay. So how to represent the numbers? 4.2626. So this lies between 4 and 5. Again, 4.2 is there. It means it lies between 4.2 and 4.3. Again, zoom 4.2 and 4.3. We get these numbers 4.21, 4.22 till 4.29. Okay. So again, we have to zoom 4.26 to 4.27. So we'll get these numbers. Again, this part is your answer. So these all are easy tasks. Again, suppose I'm asking you 5.9292. So what we have to do for this? 5.9292. Anyone can tell me for 5.9292 how to make the...
Sir, first we need to take 5 and 6, sir. It is lying between 5 and 6 numbers, sir.
Okay, 1 minute. I'll just do accordingly. 5 and 6. Okay. This lies between 5 and 6. Okay, next. This is 5. Next, this is 5.1, this is 5.9 and 5.8. Okay. Then where it lies?
5.8 and 5.9.
No. This is 5. More than 5.9. See here. This number is more than 5.9. Okay.
5.9 and 6.
Exactly. So we have to take here 5.9 and 6. Very good. So here numbers are what we can write the numbers here. 5.91, 5.92, 5.93. So keep on going till where we go? 5.99. So now where this two, now where this lies, 5.9292 between?
5.91 and 92, sir.
See, this is again greater than 5.92. Greater than 5.92. So we have to take 5.92 and 5.93.
Okay, sir.
So 5.92 and 5.93. Again, we have to zoom this part. So we get here 5.92 and 5.93. See, this meeting is going to end within a minute. Okay. Again, I'll just join with this same thing. Okay. 1 minute. This one. Again. 5.921, 5.922, 5.923, and 5.929. Okay. So again, where it lies, 5.9292? 9292, where it lies?
So 5.929 and 5.93.
Yeah, between this, okay. So we have to zoom this part.